good friend of mine, Turner, invited me to play at his church this Sunday. This Sunday also happens to be Easter, which is, you know, kind of a big deal and all. So I decided I'm going to show you guys what I do to prepare every week. The reason I do what I do is so when I start playing, I know I'm going to be confident. So the first thing that I do to start preparing myself for Sunday is I listen to the songs that we're supposed to play. I'll normally get sent a set list about a week or two in advance, and once I get the set list, I'll just listen to the songs, you know. I'll just put my headphones in while I'm doing homework, while I'm working out, you know, just doing whatever. And once I listen to the songs a few times and get familiar with them, I'll start listening to every song very, like, detailed. I'll be listening out for very specific things and really just breaking the song apart and just really analyzing what the drummer is doing. Once I've listened to it quite a few times and really inspected to see what the drummer has done, that's when I'll actually, you know, go to my kit. I've listened to the songs a bunch, so now it's time to practice.
The tomb where soldiers watched in vain was borrowed for 3 days. His body there would not remain. Our God has robbed the grave. Our God has robbed the grave.
Now it's Saturday, so I'm going to pack up all my stuff and get it ready for tomorrow. I just got done packing up all my stuff, so I'm going to show you all the gear that I'm bringing with me tomorrow to Locust Grove. So to the right of me, I got my snare. It's DW Collector Series. I got my trusty cymbal stand. Got my cymbal bag. I'm not sure if you can see it, but all my cymbals are in this little circular thing right here. And last but definitely not least, got my drumsticks. And the reason I do this Saturday night and not Sunday morning is so I can sleep in. It saves time. And, you know, since everything's in their cases already, all I've got to do is just bring them out, put them in the back of my car. So, see y'all in the morning. We'll be right back.
khaki pants, there's nothing better. The girls ask the guys, it's always a surprise. There's nothing better, baby, do you like my sweater? Sitting in the back of my next class napping, got up, gave a speech, then bowed to the clapping. Told a funny joke, got the whole class laughing. Think I got a tan from the light which I was basking. The Sadie Hawkins dance and my khaki pants, there's nothing better.
Everything turned out great, but it was definitely a process to get there. One struggle that we had was rehearsal. It wasn't that we were unprepared as a band, it was because we were playing with tracks. So, for example, say there's a song with a really beautiful cello piece in it, but you don't actually have a cello playing the part. You can put it into a track. When you play it live, it'll sound like there's actually a cello there, but there's not actually a musician playing it. However though, when you play to a track, you have to have perfect time. Say you're playing at this tempo, and the track is really at this tempo, you're just gonna clash and it's gonna sound terrible. So it's very important to have good time. So with the track comes a metronome. I was the only person that could actually hear the metronome and the track, so it was very difficult to keep everybody together because they didn't have that constant pulse in their ear of the metronome. So if a singer or a guitarist started to waver off the tempo, I kind of had a choice to either stay on it or to kind of follow them. And what I was doing in rehearsal is I was following them, and it really wasn't working out. We got off the click on every song. When it came to the service, I thought it was gonna be a train wreck. But when we started playing, everything was perfect. We didn't get off the click at all, and it went really well. So thanks for watching.